Good morning, students. Children, in the last module, we had done four sentences from this exercise, which is given in your course book, page number 123. Two more sentences were left, fifth and sixth one. And here I had added two more sentences in it, just to give you a practice of this apostrophe punctuation mark. I hope, children, you will write all these in your notebook, because punctuate the sentences should be done in the notebook, because you have to rewrite these sentences. You have to write it once more. Okay, so we will start with the sentence and we will do the sixth one, as well as we will do two more sentences which we have to rewrite again with correct punctuation mark. As you can see, it is written on the board. The question, she doesn't listen to her mother. Now, as you know that we have to start the sentence with a capital letter. So, here I have started the sentence with capital letter, which my first letter is capital she. Now, doesn't is a short form, children. Does not. Now, whenever there is a short form, we know that we have to use the correct punctuation mark, that is apostrophe, in the place of the letter or letters which we have not written. So here we have not written the letter O, like doesn't, does not. It is actually does and not. So this letter O, we have not written. So that's why in place of O, I have put an apostrophe mark. So it becomes doesn't listen to her mother, and then it is a full stop because it is a declarative or assertive sentence. Clear, children? So have you understood why we have put apostrophe here in this place? Because we have not written this O, which is a short. Coming to the next, children, number 6. There are two S in the word classy. Now if you see the word classy, C-L-A-S-S-Y. Now two S are there. So that's why they have written two S. Now when the rule says that when the word, the two words are there, or three letters are there, in one word there are two letters, or three letters are there, then we write three R's or two S. So before the last S, we put apostrophe. Before the last S, we put apostrophe. So here, we have to first start with the capital letter, there, because it is the beginning of the sentence. So T is capital, there are two S. Now see, before S I have put an apostrophe, okay? An apostrophe mark is given here in the word classy. Now already it is marked inverted commas, because it is that particular word, and then you have to put a full stop. Like I say, children, there is a word, if I say the word Twitter, one minute, I'll just show you. If I write the word Twitter, in this word Twitter, what happened? How many T's are there? How many T's? Three T's. So I can say three T's. Now where will I put the punctuation mark? That apostrophe, where will I put? Before this S. So it can be T, it can be R, it can be S, it can be P, anything. So we should know that before the last S, we have to put apostrophe. That shows how many times that word has been doubled. Okay? Coming to the seventh one, children. This sentence is being added to this exercise. Mother was taking her to Sweta's party. Now, Sweta is the name of a girl. Now, we see here it is written S also. Her name is not Sweta's. Okay? Her name is Sweta. Many of you may be knowing a girl or a woman whose name is Sweta. Okay? Now, why Sweta? S has been added because it is the name of the girls whose party it belonged to. It is Sweta's party, maybe her birthday party. Okay? So we have to start with a capital letter. Mother, capital letter, was taking her to Sweta's party. See, I have put an apostrophe here to show that it is whose party belonged to, the party belonged to Sweta. So Sweta, apostrophe, and then S. Okay, Sweta's party. And then, as usual, put the full stop to end the sentence. And the last one, this sentence that we are not writing, O. So see, in place of O, I have put the apostrophe. Is it? You cannot put apostrophe wherever you find figure or the last vowel. It is the letter or letters which you are not writing. There only you have to put the apostrophe. Now, Bighorn is the name of that girl's hostel. So it is a proper noun. So it is written capital letter, B capital, H capital. Okay, Bighorn, a girl's hostel. Now, girls is plural. Many girls. Naturally, in a hostel, a single girl cannot live. Many girls. It belong to all girls. So, girls is a plural. It's a plural. So, it can be plural also. After S, you put apostrophe. And you do not put another S. This and here again, another S you will not put. That is wrong. Okay? Already, girls, it shows that it is plural. It shows that it is plural. Already, girls, apostrophe. And then, is it? It's a, not a full stop. It should be a question mark. I'm asking a question. Isn't Big Hall a girl's hostel? We are asking a question, so it should end with a question mark, isn't it? It should not end with a full stop. Okay, so in this way, you have to do this, punctuate the sentences. Okay, thank you, children.